Hello children, good morning to all of you. How are you all? So today I think our fourth day of video classes, fourth or third I think so. And already we have completed digestion and yesterday we have started respiration. Today let us continue with the physiology of respiration. And I am very happy that you are watching the video classes very nicely. And many of you are asking your doubts, personal, impersonal, WhatsApp, and also calling us. So that shows your enthusiasm and interest. Do that, like that only you proceed. And stay really up to the exam. If you sit and study like that, definitely you will score good marks. And most important thing is, listen to your parents. Don't move out of the house unnecessarily. Maintain social distancing. That is very, very important. Health is prior, next only the remaining all things. Okay children, now let us proceed with our lesson. Now coming to that respiration, physiology of respiration. Yesterday already we started about mechanism of respiration, which is commonly called as breathing. As you all know, yesterday we discussed about inspiration and expiration. That is called as inhalation and exhalation, and also about forceful expiration. And now let us proceed to the next step in respiration, that is lung volumes and lung capacities. So by estimating the lung volumes and lung capacities, pulmonologist, by summing up the lung volumes, the lung specialist pulmonologist can decide our lung capacity. And this helps them to cure the respiratory diseases. So what are the different lung volumes we are going to study first? Some of the important lung volumes what we are going to study are tidal volume, inspiratory reserve volume, expiratory reserve volume, residual volume. Maximum need papers, if you see previous papers, from respiration, which is the most familiar question you will see means, it is from this area, lung volumes and lung capacity. Many times repeatedly they are asking mixer. So most important area you have to listen carefully, and concepts you have to practice. Here we are teaching the lesson, but by doing the bits only you can understand the varied ways of asking mixer. You have to practice number of bits at home, then only you can understand the concept full-fledged. And you will understand what are your doubts, you can ask us. Without practicing bits, how much we teach also, how much you listen also, that is waste. So practicing bits is very important step for any competitive exam. Now, what are the lung volumes? Coming to first of all, tidal volume. What is tidal volume? The amount of air a person inhales or exhales normally is called as a tidal volume. Now normally we are inhaling some amount of air and we are exhaling some amount of air. So that amount of air which is going into our respiratory system and coming out of our respiratory system normally is called as a tidal volume. Tidal volume, how much it is? It is 500 ml. The values are given to us, our work is only to remember. So normal person, normally we inhale 500 ml of air and we exhale 500 ml of air, which is referred as tidal volume. Now what is the minute tidal volume? Minute tidal volume means for one breath we are taking 500 ml of air means, then for 1 minute how much air will be going into our lungs, that gives the minute tidal volume. For that we should know the respiratory or breathing rate. So already we know breathing rate is 12 to 16 times per minute. So a person is breathing 12 to 16 times per minute. Per one breath 500 ml means, for 1 minute how much it should be? 500 into 12 or 16. So that comes to 6000 to 8000 ml is the minute tidal volume. The value may fall between 6000 to 8000. Minimum of 6000, maximum of 8000 ml is the mini tidal volume. And another most important point what we should know is all this air what we are taking inside, that is 500 ml, is available for exchange of gases up? Means no. All the air what we are inhaling is not going into the alveoli. So the respiratory system is divided into two parts, conducting part and respiratory zone. Starting from external nares up to the terminal bronchioles, we call it as a conducting part. And in the conducting part, exchange of gases will not occur. In conducting part, only the air is getting filtered, the air is getting sterilized, and also the air is getting conditioned according to the body temperature. If the outside air is very cool, it is getting warmed up according to the body temperature. And in the same way, if the outside air is very hot, it is getting cooled, it is humidified to match it with the body temperature. That is called as air conditioning. So in the conducting zone means what? From external nostrils to terminal bronchioles, we call it as conducting zone. In conducting zone, there is no exchange of gases. Only three functions take place. One is filtration of air, second is sterilization of air, third is conditioning of air. Once the air enters into the alveoli, in alveoli only exchange of gases occurs. So alveoli are considered as structural and functional units of lungs. Now in this 500 ml, 150 ml is present in conducting zone and 350 ml is going to the alveoli. So this 350 ml which is reaching the alveoli only is available for exchange of gases. And this 150 ml is present in the conducting zone and it is referred as anatomical dead space A or anatomical dead A. Dead space A. Because the conducting zone is considered as dead space because no exchange of gases is taking place there. So 150 ml is anatomical dead space A and 350 ml only available for exchange of gases. So these are all the points we are going to remember about tidal volume. Once again, I bring out the important points about tidal volume. The meaning of tidal volume is the amount of air we are inhaling or exhaling normally is referred as tidal volume. The given volume is 500 ml is the tidal volume. Then what is the mini tidal volume? By multiplying the tidal volume with the respiratory rate, we get the mini tidal volume. We know that the breathing rate is 12 to 16 times per minute by a normal healthy person. And when multiplied by 500, we get mini tidal volume as 6000 to 8000 ml is the mini tidal volume. And in the same way, we should know 150 ml is present in the conducting zone, which is referred as dead space, and this air is called as anatomical dead space air. And 350 ml is reaching the alveoli and available for exchange of gases. Then what is inspiratory reserve volume? IRV, inspiratory reserve volume, is the amount of air which we inhale forcefully in addition to tidal volume is referred as inspiratory reserve volume. The amount of air we are inhaling forcefully, like that, forcefully the amount of air what we are inhaling in addition to tidal volume is referred as inspiratory reserve volume. And the volume is given to us, that is 2500 to 3000 ml is the inspiratory reserve volume. Then what is expiratory reserve volume? The amount of air exhaled forcefully in addition to tidal volume is referred as expiratory reserve volume, and the volume is 1000 to 1100 ml. Then what about the residual volume? the amount of air remained in the lungs even after forceful exhalation is referred as residual volume. How much is the residual volume? 1000, 102, 1200 ml is the residual volume. So these are the different lung volumes. So by residual volume, what we are understanding, whenever we are exhaling, all the air in our lungs is not coming out. Some amount of air is always remained in our lungs, even after forceful exhalation. Even like Ramdev Baba in Pranayama, etc., he will be exhaling very forcefully. Even after forceful exhalation, some amount of air will be remained in the lungs, and that amount of air which remains in the lungs even after forceful exhalation is referred as residual volume. And the residual volume is 1100 to 1200 ml. And here an analytical question they will be asking in the exams. So I will give you one example. When tomorrow when you become a medico or a medical student, your doctor or a senior doctor gives you a baby and he will ask you to decide whether the baby is dead after birth or is it a stillbirth. Stillbirth meaning what? Is the baby dead inside the womb or died after getting birth? After the birth it died. How can you decide? You can take the lung tissue and when you keep it in the water, if the lung tissue floats, that shows that the baby died after birth. If the lung tissue sinks, that showed that it is a stillbirth, that it died in the womb only. How now? Because when the baby is in the womb, it will not breathe. So there will be no residual volume in its lungs. So such lungs when kept in the water, they definitely sink. But once the baby is born, the minute it is born outside, the second it is born outside, it comes on the earth, it starts breathing. So once it breathes, some amount of air will always remain in the lungs, which is called as the residual volume. So it is dead after birth means some amount of air will be there in the lungs. And such lungs are kept in the water means they float. By that they can say that the baby is dead after birth. So such analytical questions they will be asking. So one or two questions means we can give the examples in the class. But such a type of questions, hundreds are there. So it is your work to go through the bits continuously. Continuously you have to go through and read the bits thoroughly. That then only you can score good marks, children. And that is about residual volume. All the four volumes we have completed. By summing up the lung volumes, we get the lung capacities. So what are the lung capacities? What are the different lung capacities we are going to study about now? That is inspiratory capacity, which is in short form called as IC, and expiratory capacity, EC, vital capacity, VC, functional residual capacity, FRC, and total lung capacity, TLC, are the lung capacities. So what is inspiratory capacity? The total amount of air a person inhales normally after normal exhalation. The total amount of air a person inhales after normal exhalation is called as inspiratory capacity. We get inspiratory capacity by summing up TV plus IRV, inspiratory reserve volume. Already we know TV is how much, tidal volume is how much, 500 plus 2500 or max of 3000. So that gives how much? 3000 to 3500 value we can get. That is the capacity, inspiratory capacity. So like that, what is expiratory capacity? The total amount of air a person can exhale after normal inhalation is called as expiratory capacity EC, We get EC by summing up TV plus ERE. So already we know TV is 500 and ERE is how much children? It is 1000 to 1100 ml. So we get how much? 1500 to 1600 ml is the expiratory capacity. Then what is vital capacity? Vital capacity is the total amount of air a person inhales after forceful exhalation, or the total amount of air a person exhales after forceful inspiration is called as vital capacity. We get vital capacity VC by summing up PV plus IRE plus ERV. This is the vital capacity. You can sum up by yourself. 5000 plus IRV is how much? Let us take 2500 plus ERV is 1100. It goes to how much? 3000, 4600. Like that you will get the vital capacity approximately. And what is the FRC? FRC is functional residual capacity. It is the amount of air remained in the lungs after normal exhalation. Residual volume is the amount of air remained in the lungs after forceful exhalation, children. But residual capacity, functional residual capacity, is the amount of air remained in the lungs after normal exhalation. So we get FRC by summing up RV plus ERV. So we know RV is how much? 1100 to 1200. And ERV we know 1000 to 1100. Approx of 2200. Like that we get the functional residual capacity. So what is total lung capacity, TLC? The total amount of air taken into the lungs is called as total lung capacity. We get total lung capacity by summing up all the four lung volumes. What are those? TV plus IRV plus ERV plus RV gives total lung capacity. So instead of writing like that, you know TV plus IRV plus ERV is equal to what? VC. So TV plus IRV plus ERV is equal to vital capacity. So you can write it as VC plus RV. VC plus RV. So here the examiner will ask question in varied ways. If he asks you a question, TLC minus RV is equal to what? So if you are removing from total lung capacity RV, it becomes vital capacity. So TLC minus RV is equal to vital capacity. So like that the question may be asked. And he may ask you TLC minus RV plus ERV. So that is how, what is it? Inspiratory capacity. Or TLC minus RV plus IRV. So TV plus ERV is equal to expiratory capacity. So like that in varied ways, the examiner can play here. So this concept you can do only by practicing different bits. So most important concept. So you want me to repeat again? The lung capacities are inspiratory capacity, expiratory capacity, vital capacity, functional residual capacity and total lung capacity. Inspiratory capacity is the amount of air, total amount of air a person can inhale after normal exhalation. We get it by summing up TV plus IRV. Like that, expiratory capacity is the total amount of air a person can exhale after normal inhalation. Like that, what is vital capacity? Vital capacity is the total amount of air a person can inhale after forceful exhalation, or the total amount of air a person can exhale after normal inhalation, after forceful inhalation, is called as vital capacity. Then what is functional residual capacity? the total amount of air remained in the lungs. After, even after normal exhalation is called as functional residual capacity. Total lung capacity means all the lung volumes will give us the total lung capacity. So this is about the lung volumes and lung capacities. We will move to the next concept, that is exchange of gases.